Our friend and former co-host Paula Faris wrote a book about her soul-searching journey titled Called Out. And she joins us now to talk about whether this crisis took that journey into new directions. Please welcome back the fabulous woman we all know and love, Miss Paula Faris, CBC. How you doing? Are you been?
How you doing, Rookie? Okay. I miss you, ladies. I miss you so. I wish I could give you a big hug. And I just want to say, I know this is a huge technological feat to do this show every day. So thank you to all of you ladies and everybody that's working hard behind the scenes to make sure this show happens. And thanks for having me on.
Well, it is a big technical feat, and not everybody can do it. But we know you've been hunkering down with your husband and the kids. And I hear you cut somebody's hair, you cut the children's hair and your husband. What the hell? Yep. What made you do it?
I veered out of my lane and I got into a head-on car crash. That's what happened. I am not a barber and I'm not a hairstylist, but my husband asked me to cut his hair, which failed spectacularly. And then Landon, my youngest, he's 6 years old, I accidentally gave him a skater mullet, but he loves it. Now, my other son has seen the effects of both of these haircuts and said, Mom, you're not touching my hair. We're just going to let it grow. So we're all asked to step out of our comfort zone, and sometimes the result is that.
I don't know. You know, Paula, put the scissors down, okay? But anyway.
I will,
Joy. I mean, you got three kids at home. You got three kids there, and I'm assuming that they're in from kindergarten to middle school. I'm assuming that you are homeschooling them, right? That's got to be. I know my daughter is doing that, and the kid has Zoom classes and all sorts of things going on. How's it going at your house with that? I mean, how's it? Are they learning anything?
No, and that's okay. Once again, stepping out of the comfort zone. I am not, just as I'm not a hairstylist or a barber, I am not a teacher, so. Trying to give the kids a lot of grace. Joy, you should probably have some pointers being a former educator yourself, but I don't understand, like, why in the name of God does my kindergartner have the most homework of all? At this point, I tell the kids, I'd rather you just learned how to do the laundry and make your beds and, like, do stuff around the home, make dinners, things that you can actually take with you through the rest of your life. So trying to give myself and the kids lots of grace.
Well, Paula, you're in South Carolina where you've been self-isolating, and it was one of the first states to reopen some retail stores and beaches. How does that seem to be going so far? Is it surreal to see people out and about, and are people still adhering to social distancing rules?
Well, when we're out and about, I don't see a lot of people with masks, but what I will say is, yes, the governor decided to open some beaches and some small businesses, and when people are out, they are really adhering to the social distancing mechanisms. You know, people don't go near one another. When you're at the grocery store, there's like, it's like one-way streets. So people are really honoring that. And when you walk into a grocery store or another business, there's hand sanitizer or there's gloves. So people are taking the necessary precautions. But now that they've flattened the curve, they're really just trying to get the economy jump-started again. But people are being very respectful of one another down here in South Carolina.
Hey, my friend, it's Sunny. Last time you were on the show, we talked about your year of hell and the bizarre sequence of events that led you to step away from The View and also from GMA Weekend. At one point, someone threw an apple at your head just seconds before you were supposed to go live on the air, and I remember that. Nobody's ever seen this before, but you sent us footage from that incident, and let's let our viewers take a look.
Yeah.
And I remember when that happened and you sent me a clip of it. What's crazy, I thought at the time, is that you came to work the next day, even though you had a concussion. What's it like for you to watch it back now? Because I thought it was crazy that you came to work, Paula.
Yeah, I was not in a healthy space, Sunny. I mean, that's an example. Could my life get any weirder getting hit in the head with an apple in the Big Apple? But that was, you know, kind of the beginning of the season where I knew that I needed to take a step back, that I had become addicted to work, and my value had become my vocation. And I was just leaning so hard into that, that I couldn't see the forest from the trees. I couldn't see that my relationships were suffering with my husband and children. I didn't notice that my health was suffering. And then when the apple sowed happened, a miscarriage, that concussion, a head-on car crash, and influenza and pneumonia, I was like, all right, if I wasn't going to take a step back, I feel like God had to slow me down. And the tough part about all of that was, yes, stepping away from these two dream jobs is difficult, but the most difficult aspect, Sonny, and the thing I wasn't prepared for was feeling so lost. I had lost my purpose. I had lost my identity in doing. And when I stepped away, I had no idea who I was outside of this thing, outside of my career. And that's where a lot of the book picks up. Like, it's not just my story. I conduct a lot of interviews with others who've misplaced their significance and how we've really been able to root into a purpose and an identity that don't shift and shake when the times do, or when there's a personal crisis or a pandemic.
Well, Paula, in your book, you write about how your identity and self-worth had been totally defined by your career, and it took this series of personal crises for you to change that. But now, in this country and globally, so many lives are being upended by this pandemic, and there are 30 million people without their job, and people who are losing, who could possibly also, like you, be losing their sense of self-worth or purpose. What advice do you have for these people?
Well, I think that tragedy and opportunity can coexist. Yes, people are losing so much. We've lost our dwelling. We've lost our status. We have lost and misplaced our significance in things, career, that have been taken away from us. But tragedy and opportunity can exist in the same breath, Megan. And I think we've been given an opportunity to kind of reassess and then, if necessary, hit a reset button. And that takes, you know, pushing through fear many times and stepping into faith when you can't see the rest of the staircase, taking that first step. And so I do think for many of us, like the crisis that I went through, this is a global crisis. It can be an opportunity to really reset and reassess life.
Well, we are really glad that you've done that and that, you know, you're feeling more engaged in life and the world. So we're thrilled that you came to see us. Paula's new book called Out, you're welcome, Why I Traded Two Dream Jobs for a Life of True Calling is available right now. You can get it at Amazon, you can get it at Audible, it's available.